Hi and welcome to Warhammer Fantasy Battle Report. My Tomb Kings versus a friend's Warriors of Chaos army. We are using an ETC-ish kind of list build, so that's why I have 100 more points than my opponent, and it's because our closest, biggest tournament use those rules at the moment, so yeah, and this means that we are not using true line of sight, but instead simple line of sight, for example, as in the ATC rules. Hope you enjoy. So this is how it looks after the deployment. On my side I have a Screaming Skull Catapult to the far right of this picture. I also had another Screaming Skull Catapult, as you can see. A unit of chariots with standard and full command, and a Battle Sanna Bear in chariot. They also have the Banner of Swiftness. Then I have a unit of Scout Cavs, and behind them my level 4 unit with 19 archers with musician and champion. On my opponent's side you can see he has a corn chariot behind the hill, and then he has two Gorby chariots of corn, and behind the forest is his hell cannon. A unit of dogs, his Nurgle warriors with a level 2. And then you can see the base of his BSP. A unit of 4 skull crushers and a level 4 on disc. Then on the left side I have 2 war sphinxes and a hero titan in between them. And another unit of 19 archers with my level 2 equipped, as you can see, and a casket of souls, and my opponent has another corn chariot. Here you can see his equipment on his characters, or at least the equipment that came up in the game. I also have some units coming from below that are 1 Tomb Scorpion and 2 units of 3 Stalkers. So the Tomb Kings wins the role to go first, and I move, as you can see. More movement on this side, and reform my chariots and move them, like you can see. Or swift reform, but oh well. In the shooting phase I land a rock on top of one of the Gorby chariots and do 4 wounds to it, which is nice. In the medic phase I totally whiff, I try for a 5 dice casket on his skull crushers, but I roll like 9 or something, so he easily dispels it. Yeah, and then this happens. My other Screaming Skull targets his Hell Cannon. It scatters 10 inches off and lands on the top on the head of his Battle Standard Bearer. He fails, I wound him, he fails his ward save, and I do 3 wounds to him, so he's dead. Which is really nice for me. Also, as a small bonus, I kill 1 dog and they fail their panic test, so they also run. So his turn 1, he moves, as you can see. His dogs fail to rally, so they run off the board. And the red arrow indicates that his skull crushers fail a charge against my scout cast, and it was due to a failed fear test, frenzy test, I mean. More movement. Nothing else happens this turn, so my turn two, I move forward as you can see. I move my scout cav in front of his skull crushers to redirect them, and in a future turn maybe get a double or triple monster charge. More movement, I reform my chariots as you can see. I also get one stalker unit and my tomb scorpion on the board. My tomb scorpion is there for march blocking, and well, hopefully some march blocking, and to threaten his level 2 in the Nurgle war unit behind the tree, and my stalker units will hopefully be able to take care of that hell cannon in a turn or two. So the magic phase are like the first magic phase. I roll a lot of dice at Casket of Souls bounce spell, but I roll like 10 this turn, so yeah, 10 with 5 dice, good job. But in the shooting phase I also fail a bit. I only do 2 wounds to the hell cannon, and it was due to 2 of my stalkers misfiring this turn, but luckily they each only took 1 wound, so I didn't lose a model at least. So his turn 2, he moves, as you can see, he moves his wounded Gorby chariot to threaten my stalkers. And the other chariot starts the dance of death against my chariots. His skull crusher charge my scout calves just to get rid of them, and yeah. So in the medic phase I stop gateway, but he gets the bolt thrower spell of Bolt of Change, oh well, and he rolls strength 10, so he easily wounds me and do 2 wounds. At least I pass my toughness test, so I now have 6 plus regen save. So my turn 3, I move, as you can see, I abandoning my level 2, abandon the sinking ship on the left, and both my war swings is try to charge his skull crushers, but only one made it in, the one in the flank. On this side, more movement, I reform my units and move them backwards, so he will have a harder chance to catch me, or catch my chariot unit with his chariots. Also, my other stalker unit appears, and hopefully it will be able to take the last wound off the Gorbish chariot, threatening my other stalker unit's flank. So, yeah, in the shooting phase I kill his cell cannon, and I also do the last wound on the Gorby chariot, so yeah, that's nice. So in the close combat phase I have, from the magic phase, path protections up. I also have 5 plus ward save and the extra attack spell. So I'm a bit lucky and do 3 wounds to him, but he do 2 wounds to me. He lose combat, but he Styx on a leadership 8, and he's also able to reform to face me. So his turn 3, he charges his corn chariot at my archers and almost trips and die on the wall due to a dangerous terrain test, but he only takes 3 wounds on himself, so yeah, I really hoped for that 4 when he failed it, but you can't get everything right. So now my archers are probably dead, but oh well. He also moves his warriors forward to try to get out of the wood, and he's level 4 as you can see. Then this happens. So his Gorby chariot fails a frenzy test, so it has to try to charge my chariot. He must roll a double 6 to get there, and of course he rolls that double 6, so now my chariots are probably also dead. So then his other chariot moves, as you can see, to threaten my stalkers. In the medic phase he cast Gateway on my War Sphinx and do some wounds to it. I think I regrew a wound last turn, so he do I don't remember exactly, but I have 1 wound left on my War Sphinx. So yeah, he's still alive though. And I also passed my toughness test again, so now I have a 5+ regen. So yeah, after close combat he only do 1 wound to me, and I do another 3 wounds to him. So yeah, this Sphinx really wants to eat skull crushers today. But he passed his break test, and we are still in close combat. I don't even know why I'm showing you this picture really. It's pretty obvious that this chariot will destroy my archers. But yeah. And also the Gorby chariots go to town on my chariot and kill more than half the unit. And I do no wounds to him. So my turn 4, I charge both my Heer Titan and my War Sphinx into his remaining skull crushers, hoping to finish them off. I also reform my level 4's unit to get ranks and stuff if his level 4 decides to charge in or something. On this side I try to charge both my stalker units into his case warriors, just hoping to hold them up in the forest, but only one made it, and not the most important one, so yeah, they will probably die now. So in the shooting phase I land a rock on top of the chariot, the regular chariot behind the house in this picture, and do 3 wounds to it. And yeah, this is after close combat. Yeah, the Scorpius goes even more to town on my unit this turn, so I'm left with my Battle Standard Bearer with 1 wound left. But at least I hold him up so he can't charge me next turn. And on this side I forgot to take one picture, but basically I kill his skull crushers and reform, as you can see. He kills my archers, and then in his turn he charges his chariot into my Casket of Souls, and his warriors who killed my stalkers moves out of the forest. He also charges his Chaos Chariot into the rear of my stalker unit. So after close combat he kills my stalker unit with his one wound remaining chariot. Yeah, I was really hoping I would at least be able to knock that off the board, even though my stalker unit would be pretty much ineffectual for the rest of the game, but at least survive. But it wasn't meant to be. Also, his Gorby chariot of course kills my Battlestand Bear. So on this side he kills my Casket of Souls and Oran off the board, and the explosion do nothing to the chariot, and but it kills my level 2, which is unfortunate, of course, but oh well. Also, you can see from the magic phase I got another marker on my horse wings, so now it has ring and 4+, which is pretty funny, but oh well. So my turn 5, I decide not to charge my one wound left sphinx into his what is it, 2 wounds now, well, into his Chaos Warriors, because it will only give him another turn to try to grind me down. So I move, as you can see, and I will flame him instead, hoping for him to break or fail his Leadership 8 panic test. Also, my Hero Titan move down to finish off the Chaos Chariot when it comes back on the board. I also reform my Skeleton Archers, so they are facing the flank of the Gorby Chariot, and my champion are to the far right, so at least I'm hoping to neglect some of the close combat resolution he will inflict on me when he charges in. So I breathe and I do 8 wounds to the Chaos Warriors, but they pass their panic test. So his turn 5, he moves his chariot, as you can see. He's still in line of sight of the Hero Titan, so yeah. Also, he reforms his Chaos Warriors, as you can see, and moves them into the forest for some reason. He admitted it was a mistake later, but well, and the blue arrow indicates that his level 2 has moved out of the unit as well and are now preparing to cast a purple sound down my lines, which is pretty bad, but hopefully I will be able to dispel it at least. On this side, more movement, he charges his Gorby chariot into my flank of my archer unit, and his one remaining Chaos Chariot moves forward behind the house. So in the close combat phase he do 10 wounds to me. So yeah, my plan of surviving that are maybe not that great, but at least I will be able to hold him up for a while. So my last turn I charge my Hero Titan at his Chaos Chariot. Charge all my monster into his Chaos Warrior unit, hoping to finish them off. So, and in the magic phase I regrew some archers and also putting 5+ ward save on them. So hopefully they will be able to survive now, at least. But yeah, so basically I go in, do 5 wounds to him, his majority in the forest, So he needs like a snake guy or free or something, but he gets it, so yeah, that's a bummer. So his last turn, he moves, as you can see, he charges his last chariot into my Sphinx, hoping for some lucky sixes. He also moves his level 2 to try to Purple Sun again. His level 4 are only a level 1 now because of a miscast last turn, so he only has the Pink Fire of Sench spell left, and he throw it at my level 4 hoping for some lucky fail toughness test or something. But he missed. Also his Scorby Chariot kills my archers even though I have 5 plus ward save and all that. So yeah. And yeah, this happens. So his chariots go in. Remember, he can only hit the Sphinx that had a 4 plus regen from all the Sench spells. But he gets 2 lucky sixes in and kills me, even with my regen, so yeah, that's pretty bad. And to throw even more salt into the wound, I go to town on the Chaos Warriors, but he rolls pretty high on his to flee roll, and I am not able to run him down. So yeah, this is the last picture of the game, and it ended up being a draw in favor for the Chaos Warriors. So yeah, hope you enjoyed. See you next time. Bye.